Hello, everyone. In this video, we'll look at patent expiration dates. We'll start with the general rules of when patents expire, but mainly we'll be looking at the calculated patent expiration dates feature in the IFI claims database. We'll see how that information is displayed in IFI records and the ways to search it. We'll look at the calculated expiration date in a typical record, and then we'll turn to the several kinds of exceptional situations where a patent term might be either shortened or extended, and how that information is displayed and searched in IFI. So let's get started. The rule of thumb is that patent protection expires 20 years after the application was filed. That's the law in most countries, and it's been the rule in the United States since 1978. There are some exceptions, which we'll talk about, but let's begin with a typical case. We are looking at the legal status section of a U.S. patent record in IFI claims, and you see where it says that the calculated expiration date is September 25th, 2039. This calculated expiration date is simply the application date plus 20 years. If we go to the bibliographic tab for a moment, you see the application date is September 25, 2019. And the calculated expiration date can be searched in IFI using the expiration date or EXPD field. The options for the search format are much like with any other date field in Dialog. You can search for an exact date like this, or for a whole year, or select both a year and a month. You can look for a range by using a hyphen in between two date values. You can use the greater than symbol to look for expiration dates after any date or year, or use the less than symbol to look for expirations before a certain date or year. The EXPD search can be run alone or in combination with other searches, such as a patent assignee search. Here, we're looking for any Microsoft patents that are calculated to expire in 2021 or 2022. You might do this kind of search for competitive intelligence, for example, or for your own company as a way to track which of your important patents are coming up on an expiration date. Or you can limit a term search by calculated expiration date, as we see here. The use case for this would be what's called a freedom to operate search, where you're interested in using a certain type of technology and you want to know if it's currently under patent protection, or when the relevant patents are due to expire. So, the calculated expiration date search is very flexible, and it's easy to do in IFI claims. And most of the time, it's just a very straightforward calculation from the application date. But there are several reasons why a patent's lifespan might be made either shorter or longer than the norm. The most common reason by far for a patent to expire on some date other than the 20th anniversary of the application is if the patent owner fails to pay the required maintenance fees. These fees are payable 3 years after the patent is issued, then again 7 years, and again 11 years after issue. There's a 6-month payment window, then a 6-month grace period, and if the fee is not paid, the patent office will mark it expired. And when that happens, the IFI record will show it like this. The patent status entry says expired, fee related. But notice, this does not affect the calculated expiration date entry, which in this case remains searchable in the record as March 12, 2028, 20 years after the application. So if your goal is determining which patents are active and which are not, you wouldn't use the calculated expiration date search alone. That's not its purpose. For more on using the patent status indicators in IFI, I would encourage you to check out the separate video on that, and I'll put a link down in the description. There are two different ways in Title 35 of the U.S. Code for a patent owner to seek an extension or adjustment of the expiration date beyond the normal 20 years. The first would be a patent term adjustment under Section 154. If the patent office has not yet issued a patent within 3 years after the application was filed, then, depending on the reasons and other factors, the patent owner can apply for an adjustment to give the patent a later expiration date. If that request is granted, then the record in IFI reflects it in the way that you see here. Note that the original calculated expiration date of September 14, 2035 is still searchable in the EXPD field, and so is the adjusted expiration date of April 5, 2036. So both dates are kept in the record for search purposes. A patent term extension under Section 156 is something different. This has to do only with pharmaceuticals. It's part of what's known as the Hatch-Waxman Act. And this section lets the owner of a pharma patent apply for a longer period of patent protection based on delays that may have occurred not at the patent office, but in the process of testing and approval by the FDA. The idea is that an extension gives the drug company a longer opportunity to recoup the expenses involved in the long process of developing the drug and getting it approved. The calculation method is complicated, but the patent office can grant an extension of up to 5 years. Often it's shorter. And if an extension is granted, this is what it looks like in an IFI record. For search purposes, again, as in a Section 154 term adjustment, the original calculated expiration date is still searchable, but the extended expiration date is indexed as well, so either date could determine the limits of your search results. This record, for example, would be retrieved if you searched for records with an expiration date before the end of 2006, but when you looked at the record, you'd see that it was extended into 2007. By the same token, if you search for records with an expiration date during 2007, you would again get this record, but you could see that originally it was going to expire in 2006, before it was extended into 2007. This way, the EXPD search is more inclusive, and it's easy to tell from the record how the expiration date has changed. A terminal disclaimer is a type of limit on the duration of a patent. It's used, for example, when a patent owner wants to get an additional patent on an improved version of something it has patented already. But because the patents are similar, they need to overcome a rejection based on double patenting. So, if a patent is subject to a terminal disclaimer, it means that this patent will expire on the same date as another, usually older patent, held by the same owner. This can get complicated, so the IFI record does not try to calculate the possible effect of a terminal disclaimer. Instead, the record just shows the normally calculated expiration date, but it flags the presence of a terminal disclaimer, so that you can investigate further as needed. The existence of a terminal disclaimer is also noted on the face of the original patent, as we see here. So that's it. This video, by the way, is the last of a three-part series on search enhancements found in the database IFI claims. The first one was on IFI's Probable Assignee feature as a way to find patent applications that would otherwise remain hidden from assignee searches. The second was on the patent status feature in IFI, which lets you search by whether a patent is still active or not, or limit published application searches by whether they're pending or granted. And the third of these features is the calculated patent expiration dates. IFI Claims, of course, is just one of the 40 patent databases available on Dialog, and each of these databases has its own unique and helpful features to provide you with a total solution for patent searching using Dialog. For more information, here are some links to additional resources, and if you have any questions or you need some help, feel free to call the help desk at these numbers, or you can email us at customer@dialog.com. Thanks for using Dialog, and enjoy the rest of your day.